During the spring of 1997, scientists using weather satellites measured a major increase in sea surface temperatures along the equator, confirming the recurrence of the phenomenon known as El Niño. Within months, evidence began to mount of a major worldwide meteorological event. In the North Pacific Ocean, it became apparent the El Niño-driven storms would generate some of the highest swells ever measured. In October of 1997, K2, an American manufacturer of surfwear and other sports-related gear, announced a prize of $50,000 to be awarded to the surfer who would paddle into and successfully ride the largest wave of the winter. With the gauntlet laid, the world's best big wave riders went into action, accepting the challenge of the most radical winter in surfing history. This is their story. The event were fairly simple, but very different from most surfing competitions. The waiting period would span 4.5 months, ending March 15, 1998. The contest area would include every wave at every surf spot in the North Pacific Ocean, and all truly qualified watermen were invited to compete. To be considered, a surfer had to paddle into the wave under his own power and successfully complete the ride. A panel of big wave experts were assembled to serve as judges, reviewing photographs of the winner's greatest rides to choose the biggest of them all. The photographer who captured the definitive image of the winning ride would be awarded $5,000. Although the contest is open to all surf spots in the North Pacific, most experts agree the biggest rides would probably occur at one of three places: Waimea Bay on the north shore of Oahu, Todos Santos, an island break off Ensenada, Mexico, or at Mavericks at Half Moon Bay, south of San Francisco, California. Once the waiting period begins, it isn't long before the first shot is fired, and not surprisingly, it happens at Mavericks. We'll be right back. day, several noble attempts are made, but none of the biggest waves are completed. Mother Nature handily wins round one, but a new standard is set for the winner's action. Ironically, the early start to the winter is followed by many weeks of disappointing surf. Hawaii especially spends much of the winter just outside of El Nino's full aim. Surf forecaster Sean Collins of Surfline Wave Track attributes the break in the action to a high-pressure cell anchored above Hawaii, which diverts most storms and swells north towards Canada. But by the second week of January, Collins and his team begin to track a series of low-pressure systems moving off the Siberian mainland and into the Pacific Ocean. These intense storms pour swell-producing winds across huge fetches of open ocean, churning out ground swells of astonishing strength. Long-period swells are drawn like a magnet to Maverick's Reef. The potent combination ignites a series of liquid explosions. As the new year kicks off at Mavericks, it's longtime regulars like Don Curry, Mike Brummett, and Grant Washburn who take command. El Nino swell machine in gear, a new swell blasts the coast every 3 or 4 days, and spectacular rides become almost commonplace. Some of the biggest waves result in heart-stopping wipeouts. Flea Virostko and Chris Brown both come unglued on huge attempts. Months of existing on the fringe of the El Nino swell machine, one of the most potent storms ever recorded in the North Pacific takes aim on the Hawaiian Islands. The morning of January 28th dawns on what may be the biggest swell Hawaii has seen in decades. Lifeguards wisely declare a condition black and close the beaches to surfing and all other activities. Paddling into these behemoths of the sea is out of the question. Undaunted, a small group of surfers on Maui and Oahu using jet skis gain access to the show of the century. Ken Bradshaw, behind tow pilot Dan Moore, is pulled into the largest wave ever ridden at Outside Log Cabins. The ride won't qualify for the K2 prize, but Bradshaw finishes the ride a winner nonetheless. 2 days later, the giant swell draws a bead on California. The forecast is for the biggest mavericks to date, and the surfers and media who turn out are not disappointed. A few elite watermen accept the challenge, but with rogue sets sweeping in every few minutes, getting into position to actually catch a wave proves next to impossible. Getting caught inside is every surfer's worst nightmare, and for several poor souls, this day was a bad dream. Rides that are completed are well documented. With a mammoth surf prediction out on the Associated Press wire, it becomes the most publicized swell in surfing history.
Finally tonight, El Nino has caused considerable damage that hasn't stopped some people from taking El Nino on just for the fun of it. ABC's Judy Muller reports.
It's the surf of legend, the surf of a lifetime.
Nowhere are the waves bigger than near Half Moon Bay. And for some surfers, riding those waves is a chance of a lifetime, even if it means risking their lives. Kim Hunter has that report.
The high surf advisory along the central and northern California coastline drew dozens of thrill seekers. The waves were purported to be among the biggest of the season. Some say the biggest in a decade.
It's not just the size of these waves that has the surfing community buzzing. The K2 company has offered $50,000 to the surfer who can ride the biggest wave on the northern Pacific coast this winter. $5,000 will go to the photographer who can capture that moment on film.
El Nino and the crowd, you know, crowds like pumping into the, you know, surf scene and all the big waves and everything just getting bigger and bigger and the sets pouring in one after the next. They needed a competition. They said, we'll give 50 grand to the dude that, like, cops the biggest wave.
Hard thing to challenge the big waves of winter, Harold.
Michelle, we've seen some big waves generated by El Nino this week. Waves much too big for this longboard surfer to try. But the waves hitting the Southland coast pale by comparison to the monster waves I'm about to show you. Waves so big, the ground shakes under your feet while standing on the shore.
The surf is way up on the west coast, and you can blame it on El Nino. But for some gnarly surfer dudes, it is truly a tubular gift from God. Our Don Knapp hangs 10 off the coast of California.
Coast Guard surf rescue crew trains in the crashing waves off San Francisco. The crew fought a number of battles with El Nino's powerful surf this year to pull storm victims from the cold Pacific. Even higher waves slammed other shores from Canada to Mexico. Hell for storm victims, heaven for surfers.
It's quite a rush. It gets you in touch with Mother Nature and gives you a real good respect for the ocean.
It wasn't only the rush that drew surfers to El Nino's big waves. There was also the money. $50,000 put up by the K2 company for the surfer who rides the biggest wave. And another $5,000 for the photographer who records it.
When we come back, these high riders won't run from El Nino. They chase it.
Despite the media frenzy, Maverick's growing reputation as the world's scariest big wave spot is validated again and again. Neil Matthies, unfortunately, sets the standard for horror when he hurls on this massive step wave. The result is the worst multiple wave hold down ever recorded on film. Matthies' board is 12 feet long. His leash is stretched to somewhere near 20 feet straight down. He disappears from sight for nearly a minute. Terrified onlookers scan the ocean, looking to spot the missing surfer. Eventually, he surfaces and makes it back to shore under his own power.
How long do you think you were under for?
Long time.
We saw your board tombstone. Were you climbing your leash, or were you just that far under?
I couldn't do anything. I was just that far under, just getting beat.
Big wave riding is a serious matter, and water safety becomes a top priority for the winner's committed watermen. With the K2 prize at stake, surfers finally have incentive to put together carefully planned missions to ride the monster surf. For the first time on the West Coast, lifeguards on jet skis patrol the waters of both Mavericks and Todos Santos, ready to lend a hand to any surfer who finds himself in a tough spot. The result? The winner goes down as the safest on record. As the winter continues, there appears to be no end to how big the waves will get at Mavericks. Each successive swell shows that the bigger faces can, in fact, be conquered. Flea's breakthrough winter continues, and onlookers are shocked by his fearless approach. With each swell and each ride, Maverick's legend continues to grow. But it is Peter Mell, the master of Mavs, who continues to nail the wave of the day on too many days to count. By mid-February, Mel is regarded by most as the leading contender for the coveted K2 prize. February, the best big wave riders from 10 countries gather in Ensenada for the Reef Big Wave Championships at Todos Santos. With another massive storm bearing down on the west coast, the offshore buoys begin registering the effects of open ocean swells of nearly 30 feet with intervals of 25 seconds. And on this morning, contestants making the boat ride out to Todos are met with an awesome sight. Many of the world's best surfers are unnerved at the monumental conditions. And more than one famous big wave rider chooses to remain in the boat. However, there are epic rides and equally epic wipeouts. Competition proves intense. A gutsy performance by Australian helmet Tony Ray earns the second place medal. In a shocking upset, Brazilian Carlos Burle emerges as champion of the reef contest with near total mastery of the treacherous conditions. And on this day, it included just paddling out. Machismo, Borle's fellow Brazil nuts, claimed the team title. Borle gives his countrymen plenty to cheer about. But the greatest moment belongs to Taylor Knox of Carlsbad, California, who meets his destiny in the contest semifinals. With the swell building, Knox takes a dreadful beating on this late drop. Regaining his composure and paddling the 9-6 gun back out with a purpose, Knox returns to the lineup in time to face a wave unlike any other. Without hesitation, Knox strokes into the wave of a lifetime, dropping over the ledge and into surfing history. Angle reveals Taylor Knox successfully paddling into and riding a wave estimated at 52 feet, trough to crest,